I had this one dude that he was talking real big talk, saying that he knew so many people and this and that. And I kind of did believe him. To this day, I do kind of believe him, because he was on the phone with like some pretty, like, you know, some real celebrities, and I heard him. They were on a business call. But he was on some like, oh, I love your music and this and that. You can do this, you can do that. You need to believe in yourself. And then 2 seconds later, say something explicit and sexually, like, I want to do this to you and this and that. And then go back to the music. And I'm like, nigga, what? No, I was networking. Ooh. Like, and yeah, he invited me to his studio and everything. And I was just like, I didn't understand what was going on, to be honest, because he just kept going back and forth. I'm like, wait, are you trying to fuck me or are you trying to fuck with me? And to be honest, it was just like, all right, I gotta head the fuck out, because this is a big nigga and I'm small. I gotta go. So I left.
At least you asked. A lot of people just sit there weirdly and...
Yeah.
Like, it was one female, when I used to be doing shit at Kids Ultra Lounge, she was telling me, like, this one guy kept hitting on her, but I never seen it. But she was coming because I was booking her. And then, like, the time that I did see it, I'm like, why you just didn't tell him to leave you alone just then? And she was like, because, like, I'm here to do my performances. I'm like, fuck that. Like, if he putting you in a weird situation, like, say something to him now. Like, you know.
Right. Some women I've noticed they'll like go along with it and be like, oh, it's almost like they'll say he forced me, but they'll just go along with it because they feel like that's what they gotta
say do. Say that shit now, like, you know what I'm saying? Because like that's what I was explaining to her, like,
who was the guy though? He was a promoter. Okay, so maybe she thought that she didn't want to be too rude and him trying to like block her bag or for whatever reason. Even trying to put a bad name, because word of mouth is, because that was another thing that I was kind of hesitant on too with old dude, because he on the phone with all these damn celebrities. I don't want to be a total like jackass or whatever, and him talking about like, oh, if you ever see her, don't ever fuck with her, to these high ass celebrities. But to be honest, I try to like kind of think back in my head, like, that just shows character on him, you know, trying to block someone that, come on now.
But of course he ain't gonna put a good word in for you.
Exactly. So that's how dudes are. So it's like, women have to, so it's really, it's not even the women, when you say that, it's not the women for us, the men creating that type of toxic environment where I can't even be professional because you over here thinking sexually.
Okay.
What I'm saying, so you feel like it's an excuse for the women to like go along with the shit because they don't want shit.
It's not an excuse. It's really a defense. That's what it is. It's a defense because, one, I don't know what he about to do to my reputation, and two, also my safety. Because what have we seen in the news when dudes be trying to holler and we do not respond, or, you know, we reject them.
Shot in the face,
exactly. I know. So I'm just saying, and it could be in anywhere, in any situation. So that's always in the back of our minds also before we reject a man.
So I think women should be carry someone they go to the studio.
I'm just saying,
women, I hear a lot of women say they'll go to a guy's house on some business shit, and you just like, why y'all?
That's not a business thing at all. It's not a
business. And they'll be like, oh, nothing didn't happen, but
that's not a business.
That's not even worth risking it. Like,
I do feel like all y'all should have protection though, and I do feel like too, man. Like, you just gotta start. Like, you're right. You ain't gotta be a jackass, but it is a way to say, hey, you're a dude. You're making me feel extremely uncomfortable.
But they feel like it's gonna mess up their opportunity, so a lot of them don't say nothing and they'll give it up.
Some opportunities,
but the most of my date though, they give it up. I don't know what the fuck going on. So that's good that you're not just giving it up like that.